Welcome back. You're watching Big Deal. And after Warburg Pincus, we'll take it straight to Chrys Capital then. Sanjay Kukreja of Chrys Capital joined me. And he says that he is bullish on India in the long run, but definitely is cautious ahead of the elections. Chrys Capital, how is it poised right now, especially when the markets have been so volatile?
So I think we're very well placed. We've had very few, successful fundraise. As markets are volatile, it's always a good time to actually be well, from a capital raise point of view. And we wait for the opportune time to actually come and deploy more capital. So volatile times are actually decent because they can find, you can find opportunities, you can find dislocations to take advantage of and invest in the markets. In listed markets, but also listed markets form the framework for deals that happen on the private markets as well.
Right.
And there's certainly certain pockets, certain areas where, you're seeing a lot of value also emerge in the private side as well. So that's quite interesting from our point of view.
When you say value emerge in private side, any particular sectors that you have in mind?
I think we saw a very big run-up in valuations in financial services.
Yes.
Last couple of years, 3-4 years in a row. I even wrote about it in Mint, saying, look, things are quite crazy in financial services. I see a reversal of that trend.
Right.
Clearly, that has played out in the last 6-9 months. And that's here to stay. But I think that does provide, good entry opportunities for firms like ourselves, which have always been very active in financial services. Good correction is healthy.
Right.
And then provides a good framework to get in and then actually build from here on.
Okay. So are you also suggesting that we've hit the bottom, because there have been many issues that have plagued the entire financial services sector, and a lot of people are of the view that we've just seen the tip of the iceberg. So do you see further correction? Would you be a little skeptical, or you, as you said right now, that this correction is healthy and maybe provides a good entry point?
So I would break it up between banking and NBFCs.
Yes, it's a large space.
So on the banking side, I think, there has been a long tail of, recognition led by the RBI, led by the regulators, led by the companies, and therefore gross NPAs and all of that has really gone up in the country. It's probably peaked or getting close to that point where it's there. And if you, pass forward 5 years, you will definitely see a lower, a much healthier financial services banking sector than exists today. So we feel that cycle will, play out more positively. Coming to the consumer finance or NBFC space, again, there are sub-segments within that. I think consumer finance has played out reasonably well. It's the corporate side of NBFCs which has had some issues.
Yes.
There are some industry structural changes that may happen there.
Yes.
Things like, lending to promoter lending might move into fund structures as opposed to necessarily NBFC formats. So that's a trend we're seeing. May not have bottomed out on that side. Liquidity is, re-emerging. I think things are better today than they were 6 months ago or 3 months ago post IL&FS. Those are the sectors in which I think valuation has emerged, but business challenges still continue to be there.
Yes.
And that will play out. But from a private equity perspective, we're not looking at the next 1 or 2 quarters. We're essentially looking to build a business over 5 to 7 years.
Yes.
And therefore, some of these dislocations provide good entry multiples, provide good entry points to actually build businesses over the long term and create value.
Okay. So you were talking about NBFCs. Would you also look at like insurance, housing finance companies? These are the spaces, and which are the particular pockets of financial services on which you are more optimistic about?
So it's a mixed bag. I think clearly you have a lot of opportunity in these areas. We're not tapped out in housing finance. Long-term retail credit to GDP is still like 10-11%. We have a long way to grow. So structurally, the macro is strongly behind you. You have near-term problems. You have to kind of weather the crisis and also come out from there. The LAP problem has to be put behind you.
Yes.
Builder financing has to be put behind you. But long-term, there is a lot of value to be, made in that sector, and we will continue to be interested in there. I think insurance is also a great area to look at. Both general insurance and life insurance are under-penetrated.
And there are many available there.
There are assets available, there are opportunities available, so it's a good time in financial services, from Chrys Capital's perspective, and we're certainly excited about that space.
Which are the other areas that excite you right now?
So we're very strong in pharma, healthcare. We've done a lot of deals in that sector. We're still seeing opportunities there. Again, there were macro headwinds from U.S. as well as pricing pressure, DPCO, all of that. I think those things are settling. Valuations also settling. So
right.
We find good opportunities in pharma and healthcare sector as well. Business services has always been a great area for us. I don't think valuations are attractive anymore. This fair valuations may be somewhat stretched as well, but companies are still doing well. U.S. economy is still doing well. There's a threat of U.S. slowdown and therefore what that impact could be on business services. But there is still a scope for that. I think the one area, consumer is still worrisome for us because valuations there, somehow we can't make the math work. We find that quite stretched.
All right. And apart from this, do you think that exits are a challenge, especially given the volatility right now?
So I think our view on exits has been India has never been a country with a steady Excel sheet every year. You can budget a certain amount of exits. It doesn't work that way. You have to have there are windows of opportunities, and you have to be opportunistic about it. I think in the last 2 years. It's been a fantastic year for Chrys Capital because we've actually taken a number of exits, taken a lot of companies public. Eris went public, AU went public. So we're coming off of that back.
Right.
And I always say there's like 3 or 4 different businesses that we are in. We're not just in the investing business, right? We're in the fundraising business. We're in the deployment business. So when markets and valuations are relatively lower, that's when you hunker down and work, deploy more capital, work with your portfolio companies and build out, not necessarily look to optimize and exit in those environments. So certainly some plans will be, put off or linger longer from an exit point of view.
Yes.
But you'll have to, live through the cycle because this is a long tail investing business.
Right.
And there will be more opportunities in the future that will come about.
So Sanjay, one question that I've been asking all the investors to just gauge the investor sentiment is ahead of the elections and with border tension, how do you see the investment climate right now?
It's definitely cautious. There are issues, not just at a macro level in India. I mean, of course, security and all of that is a big concern, but there are issues, there's sort of global headwinds, U.S. economy, how does it play through, the trade wars. It's a very volatile environment. So we're cautiously optimistic. We've raised a new fund. So we're excited about the opportunity that might, present itself if some of these things were to play out. But we are not, rushing in at this point, and we'll be calibrated in our approach to investments.
All right. Cautiously optimistic on that note. Thank you so much, Sanjay, for joining us. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much for having me.